Who are you people? My voice is very deep, like when my dad talks, but I'm just a little boy. I don't even... Whose body is this? Whoa. There's a black spot on this hand that looks exactly like the one on my hand. My mommy says it's called a birthmark. She says I'm the only one who has this birthmark, so if I'm the only one who has this birthmark... What year is this? Where I came from, it's 1994. Me and my mommy are visiting my kind of auntie. I wanted to use the bathroom, so my kind of cousin took me to the bathroom so that I would not get lost, but somehow I still got lost in her teaching. She was showing me how to put my weenie in her. She was showing me how to put my weenie in her. I think I am a lost boy trying to crawl his way out of a hole I was pushed into by a girl grown enough to be my big sister. So I guess here I am, a trapped wound, speaking to you from a body that looks like an older version of me. I can feel him and all his rage. Yao suffers from dissociative amnesia. I think this is why I have become a blur in his brain. Childhood trauma is forgetful like that, a playground of doubts and dying details. It's why he keeps burying my six-year-old body underneath the assault. He thinks maybe it didn't happen, but hello? I know you're in there. It's not fair that your ABCs turn PTSD before you finish first grade, but none of this is your fault. Hello? Hey. I know. Now what I have always known. Thank you for hard traveling 27 years into the future to remind me that I'm not making any of this up. Six-year-old me was too good an actor in this foreplay, but that doesn't mean it was staged. It just means I had a really good acting teacher who taught me how to feel and forget, but I don't want to forget anymore. Trying to forget childhood trauma is a lifetime commitment with the potential to destroy. And I shouldn't have to die for someone else's sins.